Please stand for the pledge. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Carlsbad. Happy Monday. Today marks the start of our senior week, meaning each day this week our seniors will be anchoring for the last time. To kick things off, we're going to have Executive Council live in the studio as well as ASB talking about dodgeball. Carly Ray, what else do we have?
Yes, that's right. We're also going to have Girls Lacrosse live in the studio and Tristan on the Magic Window talk about a very unique upcoming holiday.
That's right. It's going to be such an amazing show for you guys today. And for the last time, I'm Reese Heinemann.
And I'm Carly Ray Jones.
And CHSTV starts right now. To kick things off, we're going to have a story on Lauren, a lacrosse player here at Carlsbad. Let's take a look.
My name is Lauren. I'm a lacrosse goalie, and I've been playing for 10 years.
Lauren Lorenzen, the varsity goalie for Carlsbad Girls Lacrosse, has been working hard for many years to secure her spot on a college lacrosse team.
I chose UMass Lowell. It's a school like 30 minutes out of Boston. I chose it because, well, first of all, I really like the location. I love Boston, and I've always loved the cold. And I also really like their engineering program and their coaches. Both of those things were very important to me and my family when we were looking at options.
With being goalie and captain, there are certain struggles that come with it.
You have a lot of pressure and like kind of, not like the whole game's on you, but like a lot of it is on you. Like if the team makes a mistake, it kind of is, we're kind of reflected all on you.
With Lauren's leadership on the team, there are a few things that make her hard work worth it.
It's really fun after the game when everyone like runs over to you and like, even if you have a really bad game, the team's always really good about making sure that you feel good about it, regardless of whether you played terrible or not.
Lauren is grateful for the many opportunities playing for a high school team has given her.
So playing for in high school definitely has helped me just get a lot of reps and touches and game experience. I've also gotten a lot of film from a lot of our more competitive games. So it's been really cool to have that film and kind of see what I do wrong and right and how I can improve.
Lauren's bond with her teammates has continued to inspire her to become better.
I think my bond has just like made me want to work harder because I see them working hard.
Her commitment and love for lacrosse keeps her working hard and inspires others to do the same. For CHSTV, this has been Carly Ray Jones and Reese Heineman.
Congratulations to girls varsity lacrosse for beating Del Norte last Friday night to become the D1 champions.
Attention seniors, reunion photos are happening at our local elementary schools. Please see the graphic for the dates and times for each school. Kelly Elementary will meet today at 5 p.m. for a photo followed by a pizza party at the park. Magnolia Elementary will meet on May 29th at 3:30. Hope Elementary will meet on June 5th at 3 p.m. And Jefferson, Buena Vista, and Pacific Rim will meet on June 5th at 4 p.m. Now we have Scarlett live with our new ASB Council. What's up, Scarlett?
Good morning, Carlsbad. I'm here with ASB Executive Council. So can you guys tell me everybody's title and name?
My name's Katie Nipper. I'm the secretary. And then we also have Marley Kosick, who's the sergeant at arms.
My name is Reese Cliffs. I'm the vice president. And then not present is Lily Nolte.
My name is Peyton Millard. I'm the activities director. And Asha Terrell is our treasurer.
Awesome. And what is council for people who don't know?
So ASB Council is basically, we're just in charge of the whole entire ASB class. We help out with various projects on campus and around the community.
Awesome. And what can we expect for next year?
We're going to expect a really fun year. The probability of the school spirit is going to be very high. So we're really excited and we're going to have a lot of fun new activities.
Any shout outs?
Yes, I can, period two.
Yes, I can, period one, President Lily Nolte.
Yes, I can, period one.
Sounds great. And I'll send it back to the anchors.
Lancers, please support the CHS Fashion Program this summer at the San Diego County Fair. CHS Fashion will present annual Christmas projects at the Student Showcase June 3rd through July 4th. CHS Fashion will present Barbie and Ken collection at San Diego County Fair Fashion Show June 29th at 1 p.m. Ms. Gerdich is leading an educational trip to Germany, Austria, and Switzerland in June 2025. The trip is open to any students in good standing from the graduating class of 2026. Come see Ms. Gerdich in room 3214 if you would like information or to apply for a spot on the trip.
Now we have Reese live in the studio with ASB to talk about the upcoming dodgeball tournament. Reese.
What's up, Carlsbad? I'm live here in the studio with ASB to talk a little bit about dodgeball. So what is the dodgeball tournament and how can people sign up?
It's kind of just our last spirit hurrah before we conclude this last year of high school. So feel free to sign up. You can sign up in the ASB room starting tomorrow.
Cool. And when is the first game and how many games are there going to be?
Yes, the first game is going to be on Tuesday after break. And then the games are going to be determined on how many people sign up. So once we make those brackets, it'll determine how many games there are.
Nice. And can anyone sign up?
Yes, anyone can sign up. Just head over to the ASB room tomorrow and fill in a sign up sheet with your team.
Cool. And could you tell me a little bit about the senior dinner?
Yes, the senior dinner is also going to be tomorrow, and that's going to be at 5:30 here at the school. If you haven't bought your tickets yet, you can buy them at the door, but they are going to be $30 each, so make sure you bring money for that.
Awesome. And any shout-outs?
Shout-out Mrs. Papera, period one.
Mrs. Papera, period one.
Cool. Thank you, guys, and I'll send it back to the anchors.
Thank you, Reese and ASB. Lancers, this is a reminder to be good citizens and respectful community members. Please do not park in the pool parking lot, block neighbors, driveways, or mailboxes, and pick up trash. Law enforcement will be monitoring the parked cars and issue tickets or tow. Do the right thing, Lancers.
Lancer Locker donations are needed. Donations can be dropped off in the Lancer Locker basket in the front office. Next up, we have Sebastian live with Girls Lacrosse. Sebastian.
Thank you, Reese. Good morning, Carlsbad. My name is Sebastian Ristanthopoulos, and I'm here with Reese and Clara from our girls lacrosse team who recently won the Division I championship. So, Reese, can you tell me how that game went?
Yeah, so it was a tight game against Del Norte. We were down with 20 seconds to go, but then with 2 seconds, the Lisa McGill hit a game-winning shot to go into overtime, and then she hit another game-winning shot to win the championship.
That is awesome. Congratulations. And Clara, you are a senior, so what was your favorite moment from the season?
My favorite moment from the season was probably beating Bishops in the semifinals, who has beat us every time we've played them, and in the championship last year. So
that is awesome. And looking forward into next year, what are your goals for the season?
Yeah, we're going to try to run it back, get that championship again for Carlsbad, and we got big shoes to fill because these seniors really did it well for us this year.
That is awesome. Good luck. And any shout-outs?
Yes, I can. Period one.
Period three, Hendrix.
Congrats to the girls lacrosse team once again. If you see them around campus, make sure to congratulate them. Anchors, back to you.
Thank you, Sebastian and girls lacrosse. All sophomores signed up for the AP US History, please stop by Mr. Isabel's classroom 8106 during lunch Monday, May 20th through May 24th to check in and pick up your copy of the APUSH summer assignment. In addition to picking up the summer assignment, APUSH students will need to check out a textbook from the library. Textbook windows during student breaks. Volunteers are needed for field day families with special needs on Sunday, May 26th from 10:30 to 1:30 at Holiday Park. Please contact Vicki at blueglasses.com for more info.
Seniors, remember to do the right thing, make good choices, and abide by senior behavior contracts. You do not want to lose your senior privileges and risk not participating in graduation. Now Keely and Bree are live on location to talk about the bioluminescence coming our way. Take it away, Keely.
Good morning, Lancers. I'm here at the Carlsbad State Beach to give you guys a little information on bioluminescence and red tide happening all along our coastlines. So this phenomenon only happens when there's a large algae bloom, and you can only see this phenomenon at night or when it's very, very dark and very, very cloudy. So Carlsbad, if you want to see this amazing bioluminescence, you can see it all along our Carlsbad coastlines going all the way down to the Ocean Beach Pier. Some great spots to see this are just down here at the Carlsbad State Beach, turnarounds in the Terramar Cliffs. Carlsbad, if you want to see this amazing, amazing bioluminescence, you should definitely come down any night this week to check it out. That's all I have for you today, and I'll send it back to the anchors at the desk.
Thank you, Keely. For our last segment of the show, Tristan is live on the Magic Window to talk about a unique upcoming holiday. Tristan.
That's right, good morning. I'm here to talk to you guys about a pretty special day, and that day is actually today, May 20th. So May 20th is actually World Bee Day. So World Bee Day is just a holiday where we celebrate all the bees on Earth and all the amazing things they do for our ecosystems. World Bee Day is on May 20th, and it actually falls on Anton Jansa's birthday, which is May 20th, and she was born in 1734, and she was known as the pioneer of beekeeping. So that's pretty interesting. And this holiday is just super important to celebrate because bees just do so much for our ecosystems. They give us so much produce, and they just help out our ecosystems. They actually pollinate about 90% of plant life on Earth. Considering there's other pollinators out there, this is just super impressive. And so that's why we should probably celebrate this holiday. And this is what our grocery stores look like now. We have so much fresh produce around the world, so many different kinds of plants and fruits. And without bees, this is what it would look like. It would just be so empty, and we just wouldn't be where we are today in our natural life here on Earth without bees. They just help us out so much. And I know some people are allergic to bees, and some people may be scared because they can sting you, they can hurt a little bit, and some people are pretty deathly allergic to these things, but they really aren't out to hurt anybody. They're just there to help our Earth. So maybe try not to step on some bees or just aggravate them. And so to celebrate, you guys can go pick up some honey from the grocery store and some, put it in your tea in the morning. And yeah, that's all I have for you today. Make sure to do that next year and celebrate this pretty interesting holiday. And I'm gonna send it back to Carly Ray.
Thank you, Tristan. Now we're going to take a look at tomorrow's story about Xander, a worker at Aloha Ice that strives to give Carlsbad a taste of Hawaii.
I think that there's a lot of people that crave Hawaiian shave ice, but they can't really get it out here just because it's kind of a taste of being back in Hawaii. So I think they all appreciate that.
Looks like it's going to be a great piece. Now, it's been an amazing 4 years, and I'm so thankful for everything this program has taught me.
That's right. I'm so thankful to have been in CHSTV the past 4 years, and for the last time, I'm Reese.
And I'm Carly Ray.
Bye, Carlsbad.
You know what? I'm out here because I love coaching kids.
I've noticed it just an upward trend the last, you know, 3 or 4 years even.
The future looks really bright for this program and where it's going.